Welcome to Azure Essentials. In the next few minutes, I'll walk you through how you can use Azure's global cloud platform to keep your business-critical services up and running and to protect and restore your data from a specific point in time as part of a business continuity and disaster recovery plan for your organization. In Azure, there are two core services that you'll want to take advantage of. The first is Azure Site Recovery, or ASR, and the second is Azure Backup. Both ASR and Azure Backup complement each other to provide you with an end-to-end business continuity and disaster recovery solution with unlimited scale. In the case of an outage, this allows you to recover your business services in a timely and orchestrated manner and safeguards the recovery of your data in the event of accidental deletion, corruption, and even ransomware. With ASR, you can replicate Azure VMs between Azure regions, or you can replicate on-premises VMs and physical servers to Azure. In this case, Azure Site Recovery will coordinate virtual machine and physical server failover from your primary site to Azure and can fail back to the primary location once it's running again. Additionally, Azure Site Recovery integrates with other business continuity and disaster recovery services. For example, it can protect your important SQL Server workloads by managing the failover of SQL Server always-on availability groups. ASR offers best-in-class recovery time objectives, RTO, and recovery point objectives, RPO, so that if your service goes down, it can be back up in minutes. Application-consistent snapshots, which capture disk data and transactions in process, are mapped to your specified recovery points to keep your apps consistent during failover. You can also customize the orchestration sequence for the failover and recovery of multi-tier applications running on multiple VMs. Recovery steps can be automated by taking advantage of our Azure Automation Library of application-specific scripts. Additionally, you can use your own scripts or opt to manually initiate recovery from the Azure portal. You can also customize the orchestration sequence for your failover and recovery of multi-tier applications running on multiple VMs. ASR uses the network management capabilities in Azure, such as reserving IP addresses and controlling load balancers, and can be used with Azure Traffic Manager for efficient network switchovers. Moving on to Azure Backup as part of your business continuity and disaster recovery plan, you can ensure that your important data is backed up, whether it lives on premises or in the cloud, and you can configure the service to your specific recovery point objectives. Based on your goals, Azure Backup takes multiple snapshots of your data to give you the flexibility to restore your business back to a specific period in time. For example, you can ensure that your database is backed up every 15 minutes or that your VMs are backed up daily. If you've got VMs running in Azure, you can configure backup and retention schedules to recover your VMs as well as their content, such as files and folders. The backups are application consistent in nature, and you don't need any additional infrastructure for this to work. If, on the other hand, you're looking at backing up your on-premises resources, Azure Backup gives you a wide variety of backup options. You can, for example, just choose to do a general backup of your Hyper-V and VMware virtual machines from your data center, and even capture system state on your physical machines to do a bare metal recovery if needed. Equally, you can choose to backup your files and folders or the data in specific workloads such as Exchange email data, data stored in SQL, or in SharePoint. To understand more about your backup options, it's a good idea to refer to the Azure Backup Server Protection Matrix, which also details known constraints. Once your data is copied to Azure, it will synchronize only Delta changes, saving you time and internet connection charges, and you can even ship your data offline to the Azure data center hosting your backup if that's preferable. The data is encrypted in transit and at rest, and you as the customer hold the encryption keys. With your data backed up in Azure, you can also take advantage of additional built-in protections. For example, we know that most ransomware attacks typically attempt to gain control of your backup process by deleting the previous data backups. To help mitigate this threat, when you set up Azure Backup, you can configure your recovery services vault for multi-factor authentication. This ensures that a security PIN is generated to perform critical operations, such as updating or removing a recovery point. So now let's talk a little bit about setup. I just showed you the recovery services vault, and this is an important point. Both services require you to set up a recovery services vault to hold your settings, monitoring and reports, policies, protected items, and site recovery plan, as well as backup items, backup jobs, and backup usage logs. Next, you follow a step-by-step wizard experience that walks you through the information needed to ensure that your environment is replicated and your data protected. For ASR, this includes setting the target of where your applications will land in Azure, the virtual machines you want to replicate, as well as preparing your recovery plan. And for Azure Backup, if you're backing up from Azure, you just need to select the VM resources that you want to back up, and in a few steps, you're done. The steps include selecting your backup goal, the frequencies of your backup, and how long you want to retain the backups to meet compliance purposes. If, on the other hand, you're backing up your data center resources, you need to choose the on-premises data sources that you want to back up to Azure and prep your on-premises infrastructure. Storage for your protected data comes in two flavors. LRS is a low-cost option for protecting your data from local hardware failures in Azure. GRS, on the other hand, provides a higher level of durability for your data, even if there's a regional outage. And you only pay for the storage that you consume. For the specific prerequisites and to learn more about their setup experience, visit the link shown. Of course, before you set up these services, getting the most effective use of Azure to handle a backup of your services and data takes some planning. For Azure Backup, data is kept by default for 30 days, and so you'll want to extend this period to support your specific data retention goals, which could be many years to meet your regulatory requirements. For ASR, on the other hand, you'll need to determine which VMs to replicate by assessing the impact to your business if the specific apps and workloads that you run experience downtime. To support deployment planning, the Site Recovery Deployment Planner is a command line tool that allows you to remotely profile your VMs to understand the bandwidth and storage requirements for successful replication and failover based on your recovery point objectives. You can run the tool without installing any site recovery components on premises, and it also gives you an estimated disaster recovery cost for failover to Azure. As you shift to manage failover and data backup with Azure, you also benefit from built-in monitoring tools. In Azure Site Recovery, out-of-the-box monitoring helps you to continually oversee your business continuity objectives. You can also choose to receive email notifications for critical events so that you're able to proactively address any issues that might impact your ability to react to a disaster. Furthermore, in Azure Backup, the Vault dashboard gives you visibility into the list of backup jobs, alerts for failed backup jobs, restore jobs, and delete operations. Similarly, you can set up email notifications for alerts or push monitoring data to a log analytics workspace or Power BI for a holistic view across all of your Azure subscriptions. So that was an overview of how you can use Azure's global cloud platform to keep your business critical services up and running and to protect and restore your data from a specific point in time as part of a business continuity and disaster recovery plan for your organization. Azure Site Recovery and Azure Backup are built into Azure. So if you have an Azure subscription, you can get started today, and ASR is free to use for the first 31 days. And of course, to learn more about Azure and to get access to additional learning resources, please keep checking back on Azure Essentials at the link shown. Thanks for watching.